Good afternoon. Welcome to my channel. I'm back. Today is... Just a minute. I can't. Today is the 14th of July, 2022, and finally I got to sit down to our diamond painting. I have missed my diamond painting. I don't want to complain. But I'm going to. Folks, things have been crazy here. But now everything is back in order. Hopefully we're going to get back to schedule. I'm telling you, when the windows open, I have like a meter of dust in here. Although the whole flat has been vacuumed today, we have new carpet. Drapes have been cleaned. Today's about 35 degrees centigrade, so I did not have a chance to clean the windows. So I will do it tomorrow morning. Let's say between 4 and 5 a.m. It's still cool, and the sun doesn't shine on the window. Now, I get a pretty light yellow color. The question mark symbol. Let me see what you can see here. Not much, huh? How are you doing today? Is your summer totally hectic? Or is it just me? I mean, my gosh. Now I will probably have to refill the pen. As weird as it sounds. This wax that has a tendency to dry out. This is why we always keep our wax covered, you know. Otherwise, they will become dry and brittle and they will be useless, you know, as far as picking up our beautiful diamond. These are little things that we learn to do as we go along in our diamond painting venture. Most of the stuff I learned by my own mistakes. However, I watched all the YouTube videos I could about diamond painting, you know. This is how I got the majority of my information. I love to start new crafts, but I do my research for the very simple reason, you know, I don't want to waste my money. So other YouTubers have tried out certain stores. Now, the one that is available to me right now that I can get fast shipping from is right here in Hungary. I have seen a few YouTube videos from the store, not very much, since they have not asked me to do a review. You know, I am not going to ask them. You know how it goes. very satisfied with the store. I have no complaints about it. The canvases are a good quality, of course not the highest quality, because then it would be rather unaffordable. Now, of course, I love Diamond Art Club, but I am in Eastern Europe. Actually, they told me I'm in the middle of Europe. I have to stop saying I'm in Eastern Europe. I always thought I was in Eastern Europe. Well, I stand corrected. So shipping over here from America is extremely expensive nowadays. When I do order from outside the country, I look for, deals with free shipping and things like that. Then I would order a whole bunch of diamond paintings at one time. So we are behind with a few projects, but there is no worry. You will see, we will catch up. Actually, this was our July project, a bakery fairy or bakery angel, whichever name you prefer to call her. You have not given me any suggestions as to what name shall we give her. And I don't have the slightest clue. So, anyway, she is adorable. It's my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. I need a bit more light. You know, I had to close the drapes because, as you know, from all the noise, I'm on the main street and my windows face, all of them, face the main street. But what is important in that is I get sun almost all day long. I don't have air conditioning. So in order to keep the flat bearable, you know the usual story. In the winter we complain about the heat, in the summer we complain about, in the winter we complain about the cold. Oh, is the woman confused? And in the summer we complain about the heat. That's the way we do it. Weather is always something good to complain about. So anyway, by closing the drapes, it really reduces by quite a few temperatures. The inside of the flat makes it nice and comfortable. I do have ceiling fans going. There's three of them going at the moment. And it's about 27 degrees centigrade in the flat, and about 35 degrees centigrade outside. So we're doing very well. If I had air conditioning, I really would not put it below 25 centigrade. And not to mention, we are conserving energy. Through some smart people that made some very bad decisions. But thank goodness, in Hungary we are fine. There's no shortage of anything. So far, so good. Just take it one day at a time. We will get through this also, just like we got through everything else. And it turned out just fine. I think we have learned quite a few things in this past couple of years. And one of the things we learned is that we don't really need all the stuff we thought we can't do without. I mean, with all the restrictions and lockdowns and what have you, we had to make do quite a few times. So we have experience in that aspect of living. Well, of course, here in Europe, we are used to having other circumstances. But as I said, here in Hungary, everything is fine. Everything is under control. People on the whole are behaving. They just had a little to do about certain taxes for small businesses, actually. But it was nothing to worry about. I think just a bunch of people got bored and they went walking on the bridge in Budapest. That's about what happened. But they passed the bill anyway, so, you know, they had a little outing. That's about all I can say about that. I mean, the government did try to hold the prices down to a bearable level, but there is only so much they can do, especially things that are imported. So this is another good example of buying local products. We are in summer, everything is, you know, being harvested according to the schedule of nature. And we should make use of the fresh produce. For those that have the room and the ability, definitely they should can. I actually prefer freezing. I think the flavor and the nutritional value of the food is better kept. And another way of preserving that I like is drying, dehydrating. That can also preserve and may also concentrate the nutritional value of certain foods. All the vegetables and fruit can be dehydrated. And the fruit becomes very sweet. It's a good substitute for candy. I'd rather, you know, have my child chewing on a dried fruit. And of course, he's old enough now to have a few nuts with it. These are all healthy foods, unsweetened, unsalted. So instead of giving him store-bought candies, I would rather, you know, give him that. Also to put in muffins. You can make a zillion type of different kind of muffins. Actually, whatever you have at home, you can flavor your muffins with it. You can make it from whole grain or mix the flours. Oh, what did I say the other day? They made spaghetti cupcakes. Oh, it looked so good. You know, like spaghetti. And spoon of sauce over it. A little meatball in the middle. You know, in a cupcake baking pan. So you put in each of the cup. This is how they made it. And they put a little meatball in the middle of it, cheese on top, and I stick it in the oven. And it comes out, you know, a spaghetti cupcake. She said, what a good idea. I would even think it would be a nice appetizer and an hors d'oeuvre. You know, make a meatball nice and spicy for those that like spicier ones. Don't skimp on the ingredients. So give it a good taste. Now for me, since my appetite has decreased, actually one of these cupcakes, you know, with some salad and fruit, that would be sufficient for me for dinner. I'm not kidding. And I don't know what this blasted traffic is out there. Everything was quiet, so I thought I can finally sit down and do a video. No. You know, I'm just waiting for our first responders to show up also. Usually they do. I still say maybe we have a hidden camera and they see when I sit down and go, oh, okay, let's go. She's on camera. Let's make as much noise as we can. Really? Last time they even was sirening around at 4 in the morning. I mean, they usually don't turn the sirens on until 7 a.m. and they shut them off after 7 p.m. I mean, we're running around the corner from the hospital. So they shut it off anyway at the corner so as not to disturb the patient's rest in the hospital. You know, they radio ahead, say we're coming. And then the emergency crew stand outside waiting for the ambulance. So there's really no need for them to siren. It's just a bit of a consideration for the patients and for the people living here, you know, that still may want to sleep. You know, like my husband, he works in 3 shifts also. Yes, many human has learned how to fix a car. So yesterday he was learning how to drive a big rig, one of those really big monsters. Yes. He was with Istvan. And he didn't want to come out of the truck. He wanted to go. I think this one is going to France or where he's going with that rig. Well, I told him, you get him in that behind the steering wheel and you're not gonna, you know, get him out of there. Definitely, he's a car freak. He's going to be 3 in November. He will start school, which is mandatory in this country, in September. He's already enrolled. He has learned to eat the food that he will be served in a cafeteria. We are slowly training him. So the transition from being a baby boy to a little boy will be that much simpler, you know. Well, of course, there will be a few tears. I mean, that's normal. And a lot of the tears are from the mummies. You know, we all stand outside going, oh, that baby grew up so fast. When did he get to be so big? He was just born. He spent a couple of hours getting used to the school. And they do take a nap after lunch, where our main meal is served at noon. So actually, that is his dinner. It is at least a two-course meal. Here in Hungary, it's customary to have soup as the first course. Although they have sometimes switched over to fruit juice or something like that when it's warm, then perhaps a child doesn't want to eat a hot bowl of soup. And then they have something for the second course. So some sort of protein. Now either the meat is in the soup or, you know, it's in the second course. They have cut down on the sugar and salt before we had a complaint for the child's food being too much sugar added. They claim that this way the child is more likely to eat the food. And we told the nutritionist that at home we try not to have additives. I cook everything from scratch. Now, seriously, what on earth is going on out there? What's that green truck? What's that white truck? Ooh, yes, I'm nosy. So anyway, we told the nutritionist that we are trying to have healthy eating habits for the baby. And they should consider switching. So they asked quite a few mothers to give them recipes that we use at home. Those of us that are at home on maternity leave and are not back to work yet. Usually maternity leave is for 3 years here in Hungary. And after that, the mothers go back to work. So then they will take dinner home, unless they cook at night, you know. A majority of them would take dinner home from either the school cafeteria or the nursery school cafeteria, you know, or a restaurant. So we have modernized the menus that these children get. So they are much healthier, not as chubby. You know, I thought a healthy baby should be chubby. Well, we have been taught that this is not the case. So we are raising healthy little children with proper nutrition. Actually, I tasted the cafeteria food and it's edible. Not as good as mine, you know, but I spend about 3 hours every morning cooking. We do shopping. Well, once a month we fill up the pantry with basics. And then actually we just need fresh stuff, you know, like bread and milk and fresh fruits and veggies. We eat a lot of that. So I'm happy about the way the cafeteria has switched to proper nutrition. I was worried about how the child will transition from being at home. He was rather isolated because, you know, we were all isolated. So now he's getting used to playing with other children, going to play group, going to the park, escaping from the apartment and going to the park alone, which gives mommy a nervous breakdown and a heart attack. So he's becoming independent. No, he will not walk to school alone. No, no, no. Not until he starts first grade, he's not allowed to walk to school alone. Although school is just around the corner. So things are going through a lot of change this summer. I'm sometimes overwhelmed. But it looks like things are getting back normal again, which I am happy about. So we can continue our diamond painting, spend a little time together every day. I really missed you guys, seriously. Having a little chat, rant and rave and complain and whine. Thank you for spending time with me this morning. Actually, it's afternoon. So, today is July 14, 2022, and it's the afternoon. Stay safe, stay healthy, be happy. Do something to make yourself, give yourself a little bit of joy, anything, any small thing. See you next time. Please hit the like button, and bye for now. Mwah. Bye.